Hi guys, welcome to this video. Today I'm gonna have a quick look at Elementary OS. They released their 5.1 Heron version past week. So I wanted to have a quick look on it and see how the program is doing right now. I know it's looking very much like a macOS fork. But yeah, it's based on Ubuntu. And it's they have a lot of own software packages on the system, so let's have a look. So they're introducing the OS 5.1 Hera, and there are a couple of things that are new. So they have a brand new first run experience with a greeter. They now have Snappack support directly from the App Center. There's some major updates on the system settings, interactive improvements across nearly all apps, so that's all their own apps, the latest hardware support because of the new Linux kernel. So let's go quickly over what you have. So greeter onboarding, so then they have now a new look on it. Say hello to the new greeter. Then you get a lot of screens that will help you set up your system. And we'll go over that as well. That's the onboarding. So now they have the Flatpak support in the App Center. Well, and a lot of different issues like improved mouse and touchpad settings. The screen settings, Bluetooth support. The date settings, language support, so there's the housekeeping, so cleaning up system and that kind of stuff, and delete your temporary files, delete your trashed files. Easier search, updates, calendar, and your camera support. This is the new, these are the applications that I have by default installed. So a couple of shortcut keys they changed. So some couple of simple ones like cycle workspaces, switch to new, move to the right, move to the left workspace, tile left, tile right. And you can see it's based on a Mac because this is the Mac key that they're using, not the Windows key or the mod key. So they really have taken a look at the macOS system and they are trying to do a fork of it in Linux. A couple of nice wallpapers. So, and they've done a couple of things. So let's have a look. We're gonna try or install Elementary OS. Nice splash screen. Memory, 4 CPUs, so it should be enough to run the system easily. So we're gonna install Elementary OS. The default language is English. English US, that's fine. This is a Dutch keyboard with a US keyboard with a Euro on the 5. So this is my keyboard. Download updates while installing Elementary, that's fine. Install third-party software for graphics and Wi-Fi and hardware and additional media formats. I would always select that for your ease of use. Click continue. Okay, so it's detected my disk. This is a virtual machine, so I created a separate disk for it, so we can erase a disk and install Elementary. I don't want to encrypt it. I don't want to use LVM, and something else is something what I would do if I would be installing it on my system, but I'm not. So this is a virtual machine just to go to the installation and do a quick review of the quick run through of the system. So we're doing install now. We have another pop-up. Are you sure you want to write everything to the disk? Yes, I am sure. He detected that I am in Amsterdam, so that's good. And I'm gonna create my user. So, put in my password. Passwords do not match. It's very nice. I don't want to log in automatically, requiring my password to log in. Yes. So, continue. So, it's now installing the files. So I'll pause the video and we'll speed up the video and we'll start from where we can reboot the system. Okay, the installation has been done, so we're back now to our normal speed, and we're gonna restart the system. So we press enter. And let's see what it does. Put it to full screen again. And here we are at the login screen. So this is the default way. So shut down, restart button, the time, date, and of course your login. So, let's log in. And here we are being welcomed by the system. So basically, just go over an overview. You have a couple of things here on the right. So here are the usuals, like the user account settings, your log, logout, suspend or shut down. Then you have the Do Not Disturb icon, so you can activate Do Not Disturb. Your network settings, so we're wired, or you can go into your network settings. Your sound, volume, and sound settings. In the middle, we have our calendar with even date and time settings. On the left, we have the application menu. So let's get a bit of a better screen display setting. Let's see if we have mirror displays, unknown display. Can I set it a bit normal? So let's apply that one. Yay. Keep this configuration. So this is a better overview. So You're greeted with this welcome screen. So if we get to the basic guide, community support, okay, involved. If we go to the next, location services. Do you want to enable location services or not? I would normally not enable location services. But if you have a laptop or so and you want to do automatic route and that kind of stuff, location service might be very welcome. Nightlight. I would enable night lights. Housekeeping. I want to do temporary files and trash files. And then we can go to the App Center. So if I would click here, it will open the App Center. Next, and we're ready to go. We can open the system settings and just get started. We'll go over the system settings maybe in a bit. So we have a nice wallpaper. If I right click on the desktop, it does nothing. So we cannot place any folders or files on the desktop. By default, right click does nothing to change all the kind of things. We have here the App Center in the settings, photos, videos, music, calendar, mail, Epiphany as web browser, and the multitasking view, so you can have several work. Let's see what kind of applications. Photos, it is their own application, if it, I'm not mistaken. Yeah, this is all their own application that they create. So videos as well. Also their own application. Music. Looks pretty simple. Looks very nice and bright. Calendar. So this is the calendar overview. The mail client. No, okay, you have to log in and get the mail. And Epiphany as your web browser. So in the menu, you have the same things here and a couple of extra, so like the calculator, the camera, code, your files. Strange that it's not in your doc, so I would do keep in doc. I also think that they created their own file browser. But it looks very simple and easy. Looking good. What else? Files, mail, we started multitasking in videos, terminal. It's also strange that it's not by default in the dock. So they have also their own terminal. Let's check the kernel here. So the kernel is 5.0 and based on Ubuntu 18.4.1. And you have a screenshot as well. So you can have two ways to open the menu, so like this, or you can specify it on group. This makes more sense to me than the complete overview, especially if you have multiple applications that you install. So if you go to the App Center, you can search for the apps and they have some updates ready. although it's not much, just one. And you can here see all the applications that are installed. Okay. So let's go to the settings. What can we tweak and do? Applications, so these are the default applications you can set. You can start up applications. You can go to the desktop. So here we have the wallpapers that we can use. There are a couple of nice ones on it. I like the one that you're using, but this is also a very nice one, or this one, or this. Would also be very cute. Yep. This one is also very nice. Nice and bright. Nice forest overview. So a couple of nice wallpapers. On the appearance, what can we do? Windows animations on or off, panel translucency on or off, text size. I will do small, default, large, larger, but default is fine. The dock, would you do small, normal, or large? Any Windows overlays the dock, or do you want it to have a focused Windows overlap at the dock? That kind of things. And we have the hot corners. We can set hot corners to do a couple of things. So multitasking overview or maximize current window, show applications menu, show all windows. Let's go to all settings again. Language and region, I won't go over that. Notification center. So what do you want to be notified about, and what do you want it to look at? Privacy and security. So what do you want to keep in your history? Firewall. So it's by default off, so you have to unlock it, type in your password, and you can turn it on. Housekeeping was already enabled. You can set the days here. Location services we have disabled. Lock on suspend, lock on the screen. So the history, what do you want to keep? So, okay. Oh, we go to the settings again. Display we already went through. So here you have the hello DPI or the pixel settings, the nightlight, we turned it on, sunrise to sunset is by default, want to do the warmth or not, display, detect display, and we add here the settings, use this display, resolution, screen rotation, and the refresh rate. Keyboard. Shortcut keys here again, workspaces, screenshots, applications. So here you have a lot of things. So Windows key on what key, and plus the T will open a terminal as example. Okay, behavior. Repeat keys, cursor blinking, and that kind of stuff. Mousepad. So we now have a normal mouse. Primary button is on the left for me. Double click speed. Long press second click. Middle click pause. Paste. You can all that kind of things. Your pointer. And if you would have a touchpad, what do you want to do? Natural scrolling, two-finger scrolling, physical clicking, multi-touch, and that kind of stuff. Your power settings. Your printers, if you would have one. Your sound settings. Network, your online accounts. So you can have your email, Fastmail, and Last.fm. So they're missing a couple of them, like by default, like the Gmail. What I would expect to see, Twitter, Facebook, if you want to integrate that. Sharing, do you want to share your machine with music, videos, and pictures? About, so here we have Elementary OS Hera, the Linux kernel, the GTK version, and this is the machine. Date and time. That doesn't do much, thanks. Completely hangs now. At least this part. So let's close it. If I could. So force quit. That was a nice hang up. So let's click date and time again. So do you want to have AM, PM, or do you want to have the 24-hour clock? Do you want to have network time or not? Do you want to enable week numbers? I would. Parental control. If you have multiple users, you can configure parental controls for your kids, universal access, and your user accounts. So you can unlock it, you can add user accounts, and then you have to unlock it again. So and then you can have the standard user or administrator, your name, username, password, that kind of stuff, and based on that you can also enable the parental controls. So yeah, it's a system that is not very tweakable, but as it is based on Ubuntu, there's a lot of software that you can install on it. It looks the way it looks. Yeah, it's a nice system for people coming from a Mac that are used to being very closed up and not being able to modify as much as we would in other distributions. It does look like a very nice system. I'm not sure about the stability though, because we saw already the system settings hanging. But if you go to the software, there's a lot of nice software that you can install, because yet, like I said, it is based on Ubuntu, and also the Flatpaks are integrated. So yeah, looks very good, and their own applications, or you can start using other applications like the Office. It's probably like if I would search for LibreOffice. LibreOffice. Why didn't it find it? Libre. No results. Okay. Nice. If I could type today, Libre. Okay. Well, the search is a bit off. But probably if we go through this, LibreOffice should be able to be found. You can install everything. So here you have the LibreOffice. But strange if you do the type that it doesn't show up. So yeah, there are a couple of strange things in it. But looking okay. Also, you will find that they are asking for some money for some applications. But you can also set it to null if you want to use the application without providing some money to the developer. But also, it would be very nice if you really use the applications, that you can give some money to the one that's developing it. Not needed, but it would be kind to do so. So yeah, Elementary OS looking good. It would not be my kind of distribution, but for a beginner coming from a Mac or maybe even from a Windows machine, it can be very cute and very nice to work with. It's based on Ubuntu LTS, so it should be pretty stable. So yeah, have fun, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.